As of 2013, actually, the Dutch government instituted a new law on education. It's called the Law on Quality and Diversity in Education in the Netherlands. And that entailed, for example, the decentralization of their educational system. Before, it was centralized in a format that if you had a HAVO diploma, you automatically had admittance to a HBO institute in the Netherlands. That has changed somewhat now, where besides your HAVO diploma, you would need to meet additional criteria, admissions criteria established by the university or the HBO school that you're going to. So it's not automatic admittance anymore based on your diploma alone, which was the case before. And that law came about. So as of last year, for example, our students here in St. Maarten, the next change that took place was that there was a mandatory study check. And that came about via that law. So that means that students, the school, once you apply to the school, you would have a Skype interview with the school, because the law basically, we lobbied that our students here were accommodated. So you have a Skype interview where they test or, you know, question to see if the study is really a study for you. While the study check is not a mandatory determining factor, the school can decide based on the study check to say we're not gonna admit you, but they would just not base it on the study check. They would find some other admittance criteria too. Besides that, we saw the popular studies in the Netherlands becoming lottery based. So economics, arts, dance, marketing, business, those are the popular, some of the popular studies, those have become lottery based, and the lottery is mainly covered by the school themselves. St. Maarten, the Netherlands Antilles had guaranteed spots for lottery studies. Come 2016, we're going to lose those also. And that is also related to the change in this new law. So we had, for example, 6 guaranteed spaces at HBO and university level. As of 2016, that's gonna change. But for now, we still have them. So students who are applying into lottery studies, they can also apply for a ministerial spot. That the application process goes via the Division of Exams, which is located at the Brooks Towers. And their brochures are also available on the website, the government websites, to download about the process, how you go about applying for a ministerial place. The University of St. Maarten, of course, is subsidized partially by the government of St. Maarten, which means that under the study financing program, any study available at the University of St. Maarten, you're required to do it at that institution, because we support our local institutions. University of St. Maarten right now offers the General Liberal Arts Associates. You can get a Business Associates, an Accounting Associates, and they have the Bachelor in Education program and also the Hospitality program. What we have seen, while persons may not want to choose and go to great lengths not to choose USM, what we see, for example, from students who have attended USM and transferred, because the credits earned at USM are transferable to US institutions. So we have specific agreements with institutions like Johnson & Wales for the hospitality program, Monroe also for the hospitality program. So if you do your associates at USM, you can transfer to either Johnson & Wales or Monroe College in Rhode Island for the bachelor part of your study. And we see a very high success rate in those students. Besides that, we have also FAMU in Tallahassee, where they accept the full credits from the University of St. Maarten. So if you want to pursue a degree in engineering, psychology, or whatever, teaching, after obtaining your general liberal arts at USM, you can transfer also to those schools. So we have some options, and schools in Canada also accept Mount St. Vincent University in Canada and other universities, they evaluate the credits and also accept the credits from USM. So USM is a very good option, especially in cases where parents want to keep their kids on the island for a number of years, or in cases where a person is already working and, you know, may want to work on for a couple of years and balance studying and working together and not want to leave at that moment. You know, it's a very good option, and we support the University of St. Martin full-fledged.
The application form, first and foremost, must be filled in. A proof of Dutch nationality from the census office and a copy of the passport. An original birth certificate. If the applicant was born outside the former Netherlands Antilles, the original birth certificate must have the apostille stamp. A detailed registration from the census office. A valid health certificate. A tax assessment statement from the Inspectorate of Taxes supporting parental income for 2013. Most recent grades or report card transcript of a high school, proof of application or admittance to the educational institute, a copy of the career interest test, and two recent passport pictures.
Well, the procedures are quite simple. They can visit our website at www.studyfinancing.sx or www.study-sxm.org. All information is there in regards to the priority list, the application form, and all information regarding to study financing. We really prompt students to use the website because we want them to take the initiative to read the information given so that they don't come and access redundant questions. After reading the information, if they really need more information because some stuff is unclear, then they come to make appointment with one of the study financing, like myself and my colleague.
Well, the students, for the maximum amount, for the students that are going to the US, Canada, England, they come into consideration for that $15,000. It is all dependent on where you're studying, the amount of financing that you're going to receive. A good example is students studying in the Tallahassee area. We have an in-state tuition. We get in-state tuition because we have the Tallahassee Sister City Agreement. And students attending the FSU or FAMU, they can qualify for going to school there for like $12,000 per semester. So it saves the government a whole lot of money.
For Curaçao, we give, for some schools, we give 11,500 guilders, some 7,500 guilders, 9,000 guilders. So it really varies per country and school.
Your grades must be good, of course. You must be of Dutch nationality, like I've mentioned before. And all of those things are taken into consideration. So first and foremost, your grades must be up to par.
They have to possess the Dutch nationality. They have to be between the ages of 18 to 26. They have to live in St. Martin 5 years prior to applying for study financing. And they have to have the valid documents like birth certificate, valid tax papers of the parents from the previous year. So those are the persons that qualified for study financing. And they must obtain a secondary education degree.
However, some exemptions are made for students that are below the ages of 18. We have some students that complete high school before the age of 18. And for those students, we don't give them a hard time because, of course, you're not going to penalize a child for graduating early. So in those cases, we do make exemptions for students that are below the ages of 18 to have the opportunity once they're doing well and they fit the criteria for the other stuff to leave to go to study. The most important thing for the parents is having their taxes in order. Sometimes that is one of the major stumbling blocks for study financing. Your taxes must be in order too. You must be contributing towards the coffers of St. Martin in order to receive study financing. So that is one of the things that they should really pay attention to, that they file their taxes and everything is up to date.
Parents can assist by giving in their tax papers and stuff like that, but we really want the students to take the initiative and know that they're gonna pursue tertiary education, and they should be the ones to come and apply and get the information. Parents could also get the information to be abreast of what's going on and what their child is getting into, but we really prompt the students to come and do so.
The way that I see it, we don't punish a child for graduating at an early age. exemptions are made for those students. The students, as long as their grades are up to par and they meet the application criteria, they will be granted study financing. But I must mention, the decisions are not made by us at the department. The decisions are made by a committee that is chosen by, of course, the Ministry of Education. And once they make their preliminary decisions, the final decision comes from the Minister of Education. So that's the final say there. If by any chance that decision is turned down, once you receive that decision, you have 6 weeks to appeal your case. What will happen is they will call you in for a hearing, if need be. And once you come into that hearing, they'll contact you. That's a different committee that you'll meet with besides the study financing committee. They're known as the appeals committee, which is sort of a neutral body. And they would invite you in to voice your case. And once their decision is made, of course, it's then finalized by the minister again. And once that is done, then we'll see whether you have study financing or not. In the cases where you did not receive study financing, then you'll have to probably reapply for the following year.
We will not jeopardize the student if they're graduating before 18. That's great. They can apply for study financing. However, for Holland, it's a bit more tricky. Let's say, for example, those who want to do a bachelor's or university degree in Holland, the Dutch government funds them as of October. However, if they want to do an MBO degree, the government of St. Maarten will have to fund them until they're 18, and that's more costly for the government of St. Maarten. So it all varies where the student will want to go to study in Holland. It's more costly. However, if they want to study in the region, no problem. They can apply.
We have a lot of students that has problems with parents, sometimes with both parents, sometimes with one parent. And what we did on our application form now is that we made a section where you can exclude your parents, you can exclude your mom, or you can exclude your dad, or you can exclude two parents. However, you must have a valid letter from someone that knows your case, like a psychologist, or a school guidance counselor, or a court of guardianship. Bear in mind, you can only go to the court of guardianship if you've had previous relations with them. So if they don't know anything about your situation, it makes no sense going to them because they don't know of your case.
However, there are three cases where they can exclude a parent. The first case, if there is inconciliable differences, a conflict with a parent. Secondly, if there is no contact with that parent for more than 5 years. Thirdly, if there is no structural financial support.
We recently came up with a policy on promoting studying in the region. This is based also on agreements that have been made with the Netherlands, whereby the Netherlands have been providing through a bilateral cooperation agreement some funding to promote studying in the region. And the main reasons for this is because we have been noticing, for example, for the last 5-6 years, or most of our students would go to the Netherlands, and our return on investment and the educational success rates in the Netherlands has not been what we wanted it to be. As opposed to that, if we compare the results, for example, from students who are studying in the region, and I must elaborate that the region we mean USA, Canada, the Caribbean, entire Caribbean region, Curacao, Aruba, Bonaire. If we notice the success rate from those students and the return on investment, what we get, it's much higher. For example, in the Netherlands, the students that were sent last year in 2013 to the Netherlands, 55% of those students changed their study in the first year, and that was mainly due to a binding study advice. So that means that they did not obtain at least 38 ECTS or study points. And the school told them that they had to leave the study. Compared to that, students in the region, 95% of those students were successful in completing their first year of study. So we have noticed that it's in our students' best interest to pursue a study in the region. Of course, it's gonna take a change in mindset and also some more additional preparation on behalf of the parents and students to be able to study in the region. Why I say that, one of the main reasons why persons choose for the Netherlands is because of the financing that they receive from the Dutch government. And also the so transitional wise, if you want to go to the Netherlands with the funding that we provide for you, you can just get on the plane and you're in the Netherlands, you have housing, everything is set up and arranged for you. So the hurdle is very small. But on the other hand, adapting in the Netherlands and actually meeting the educational goals what you're there for, that is much more difficult. So for the region, the benefits are that the return on investment is much higher. We get more students go and complete their studies in the allotted time that they receive study financing compared to, so 4 to 5 years, compared to in the Netherlands, 7 to 8 years of studies, which means also that the cost, while initially the startup cost in the Netherlands is cheaper, when you're studying longer in the Netherlands, means that it becomes more expensive. So we already seen scenarios where the difference in cost is already beginning to equalize itself. Furthermore, the universities and college in the regions provide much more support for the students, support and guidance for the students. Just taking an example of the American and Canadian educational systems, it's more a build-up system where you can start off at a lower level and gradually build up, while in the Netherlands, you must meet that standard as soon as you go in. The Netherlands, the universities and colleges are also becoming much more selective. So they have placed selection criteria on the students that they are admitting also. So much more hurdles are being imposed for our students to actually become enrolled in programs in the Netherlands.
Okay, from my personal experience, I handle the US. And with the US students, they're considered the region. And I try to promote that because we see a greater success rate from the students that study in the US or Canada, for example, in comparison to the students that go to Holland. Within 4 to 5 years, we see students back with a bachelor's degree. Whereas in Holland, they take a longer time because they have more freedom. They're Dutch citizens. They don't need permission to live there. So you know that when they go to the US, they're going for a purpose, and they have to return back after a certain time.
Well, we pay a one-way ticket to their place of study, which is the Netherlands. We pay the insurance for them monthly. We also pay book money twice a year. That's in September and February. And also, we accommodate them for 1 year, so we find housing for them for 1 year. But this cost is on them. However, seeing that they are not in the Netherlands as yet, our representative office, the S4 Foundation, covers the cost, the deposit, and the first month's rent until the students arrive, and then the student will have to discuss with S4 how they will pay them back.
Like I said, it's dependent on where you go to. I'll give an example for the US. The US students are granted $15,000 per year. However, we don't give them the $15,000 one time. The student would have to sign a contract with government that they're accepting the study financing. They would have to open a bank account. We insure our students at NAGICO. All our students are insured. The payments are paid in two installments. The first installment is $7,500, and they get an additional 700 guilders for that first. That's just to help you out with any little knickknacks that you need to handle. Your first trip to your place of study is covered by government. After your second year of study, you get a vacation trip back. It's a round-trip ticket to the maximum of 1,000 guilders. If the ticket is beyond that amount, then you'll have to pay the difference. And upon completion of your studies, a one-way ticket back. We also give a loan for a computer to the maximum of $800, or for anything that you need to do. That $800 can be for school material, for example. It doesn't necessarily have to be for a computer.
However, for Holland, we just pay for those stuff that I mentioned. The main financial aid comes from the Dutch government. So DUO, which is DUO, and they pay them monthly. And it varies. If you're an MBA student, it's 700 something euros. And if you're a HBO way student, it can be between 9 to 1,000 euros monthly.
There's one big main distinction is, for example, the Netherlands, where because we are Dutch citizens, we qualify for study financing from the Dutch government. And there we only provide a supplementary study financing package. So we provide insurance, we provide supervision, we provide also tickets and computer loans if you need such. But the regular financing comes from the Dutch government. Our main cost in the Netherlands is for supervision and guidance. The financing now for the other countries, they are directly financed from the government of St. Maarten. So we cover tuition, college expenses. So that amount is much higher. And for example, for if you're going to a full-fledged college or university, it would be about 15,000. If you're going into a specialization, and that's important. So you're after you, for example, you've obtained your pre-med degree, your bachelor's in medicine, and you want to become a doctor, a physician, it's increased to 25,000 US. Currently, however, we have an agreement with EUC Medical College here in St. Maarten, where a number of students, we get a number of free scholarships annually. So that is significantly gonna reduce the amount that a student, because we give 25,000, but it's approximately 40 to 50,000 that you would have to pay if you're going to medical school. So they can do that here on St. Maarten. And we have free scholarships and we have 50% discount on tuition and other fees for all residents of St. Maarten who qualify and meet the criteria. For the Caribbean region, it's dependent on the island, for example, because on Curacao, Aruba, where education is pretty cheap, the amounts are maximum 13,500 guilders. And in the Caribbean, Trinidad and Barbados, we've just increased Barbados because the University of the West Indies is compared to other schools pretty expensive for us. If we obtain membership into CARICOM, we'll see a full membership into CARICOM, we'll see a reduction in that amount. So that has just been increased to about 15,000 also.
One must maintain a GPA of a 2.5 or higher. You must be attending school for at least 12 credits for that semester. That's for US students. We have students in Curacao and Aruba as well, but they have their own criteria. We expect you to stick to the study that you were granted for. If by any chance you have to change, you must send a written request into the minister. And once that's approved, then you can probably go ahead and study that. If it's not approved, you'll have to stick to the study or lose the study financing.
July 15th yearly, you have to submit a proof of enrollment that you are enrolled in the study that you were granted for. And of course, you have to provide grades so that we could check your academic performance, if you're in school and how you're doing, how you're progressing. And also they have to submit the taxes of the parents from the previous year to maintain their study financing.
The procedures actually has not changed. We request the student, of course, before changing into any study, it's always good to do a career test, interest test, to really determine that you know, besides your intuition or your feeling that you like it, that you really, that this is really an area of study for you. And as such, we have also included that in the application. So students must now submit a career interest test. We do not judge them 100% on it, but in case of doubt, it can be used as one of the criteria. Then you have to motivate your choice for the change. And we also insist that the choice remain within a choice on the priority list. So if you decided, for example, that you, in the beginning, you want to be a teacher, and later on you decide, no, I want to do marketing, then you would have to motivate your choice and get seek approval from the minister before changing your study. And that would be worked on by the department. But it's basically the process is still the same. However, we are much more stringent and we don't allow persons to change without the proper authorization.
Well, for me, I really look at the student himself to see if they're really prepared. And what I see here in our culture, I guess, is that the parents baby their children too much. They come and do everything for their child. And I really would like that if a student's applying for study financing, that they come and apply. They come and research the information, because in the end, they're the one that will be doing their study. I would like to see them more responsible, because it plays a great role later on. Because if mommy does everything financially, cooks for you, it will have a great effect with you when you go study abroad, not only in the Netherlands, but the other countries as well. Because if mommy cooks for you, does your financial, and now you're studying abroad on your own, you will be lost. And it will also have an effect on your education, because you will not be focused, then you will have to go out and get a job. So I will really tell the students to be focused, take the initiative, do your own research, and try to do everything on your own.
We're sending you away to study. You have to be serious about it, because there's a lot of students that would love to have study financing. And it's not a joke. A lot of times you hear students say, oh, we come back here, we don't get a job. We can't get this and we can't get that. But if you choose a priority study that is on that priorities list, the idea of having that priority list is those are the things that we're gonna need in 4 to 5 years. And if you contribute towards your education and studying what you got study financing for, it should make it an easier process when you come back to the island.